Hey folks, Ray from DCRainmaker.com here. Today I'm in the NoSeal stand with our new NoSeal Connect product. Now this is an aero sensor here on the front of the bike, and it's something they've been working on for a couple years now. So Eurobike for the last 3 years, we've seen them iterate through different variants of this from a prototype standpoint, but now they're to the point where they're only a week away from shipping. So next week, they're starting to actually do this whole shipping road tour thing, which I'll talk about in just a second. But first, let's talk a little bit on the tech side. So what we have here is the aero sensor, and it's going ahead and it's pulling in basically the wind speed coming off of as you're riding through your bike or riding the bike down the road there, and it's giving you real-time aerodynamic information on your Garmin Edge device or any sort of Connect IQ capable device. That allows you to see, for example, CDA, which is kind of this metric of what you're doing from an aerodynamic standpoint. So, you know, if you were to sit up, it would show a higher value because you're no longer as aero. If you were to get down better in the aero position, show a lower value. If you change things like hand positions or shoulders and whatnot, continues to get lower. And of course, the goal with a lot of these systems is on-road data, as opposed to a wind tunnel or velodrome where you're getting that data only when you're at the facility. This is something you can use on a race or on race day to make those adjustments in real time, because if you're 3 or 4 hours down the road on a race, you're probably not gonna remember all the nuances of a wind tunnel. So what they're doing is actually kind of interesting behind the scenes, is that when you start a ride, they're capturing that data both in the device itself as well as on the head unit on Garmin side. And then after that ride, you can go ahead and sync those two data files up. So this is paired via Bluetooth Smart to your phone. This, of course, gets however it gets to Garmin Connect. And then their platform takes the file automatically from Garmin Connect after you link your account together, pulls it with the high-res data from this, and gives much more high-fidelity data that you can analyze on their platform. So really, really cool stuff. And it's something I played around with last summer. I did actually a very brief test ride. I never wrote about it, never did anything, but I did a brief test ride here at Eurobike last summer with a prototype of that. So it's really cool to see now a year later that they're at a point of actually shipping in production. And so the way they're doing the shipping is also really, really interesting, because what they're doing is they're doing this road tour starting next week, first in Montreal where they're based, then they're going out beyond that. So they're going the rest of North America and Canada over the course of the summer, and then into Europe over the course of the fall. Though there are some exceptions to that. For example, they'll be at Ironman Copenhagen on August 18th, 19th territory. So that's pretty cool. But you sign up for essentially a class. You sign up for this half-day class, you go there, and you get the aero sensor as part of this bundle. So you're paying for the aero sensor the normal price of roughly $950. But as part of that, you're actually getting a 3-hour course on how to use it, how to test with it, and all that kind of stuff, which is pretty unusual. And it's brilliant from their standpoint, because it's a way to like slow that beta process. So they're not just shipping units out like on day one and having people screw up aero testing, because it's kind of hard to do. It's kind of hard to understand at first. And so this gives them a chance to get that feedback, figure out what works, what doesn't work, and then be able to, before they start shipping out units, without that class portion. So on their site, they've got like a calendar that you can look up and see when it's coming to your city. They did say that right now it just shows Montreal as far as the dates, but starting in the next couple weeks, they're going to load the dates in for the rest of the cities on that calendar. And you can sign up and do all that kind of stuff. So really cool stuff. I'm looking to do some testing here in the summer with it. So we're finalizing the exact date that I will have the DCR roadshow date, if you will, that they'll come in and do it and work with me to kind of test it and settle up, and then I'll use it for a couple weeks and or longer and report back with a full in-depth review at that point in time on how well it works from an aero testing standpoint. Again, this is really targeted heavily at the triathlon TT market crowd more than your kind of road bike crowd, but super, super important stuff. I think it's really going to change the entire triathlon industry because people can make those adjustments on the bike as opposed to just hoping for the best. So with that, thanks for watching. If you found this interesting, whack that like button at the bottom there, or the subscribe button. Also, don't forget the entire Eurobike playlist up there in the corner. There's tons of videos there, tons more to come, lots and lots of good stuff here. Have a good one.